Hi, my name is Jasper. I'm one of the co-founders of Fortune 8 and the EP of Stolen.
And I'm Taka Svoboda. I am the director and writer of this film, Stolen.
We also recently premiered it last Friday, February 8th, at the Japanese American National Museum. So today we're going to be analyzing a specific scene within this directorial debut of Taka's.
So we're about to watch a scene. It's towards the end of the first act where a parent of this child who was kidnapped, allegedly kidnapped by North Korean agents, is on TV actually trying to prove to the world that they are in fact innocent.
そして多くの人が哲也君の家族、そして未だ消息のつかめない過去の拉致被害者の家族を心から応援しています。しかし同時にネットから発症したある噂により柊木家についての議論が巻き起こっているのも事実です。今日はこのことについてご両親の方から特別にお話をしていただけるということで間違いないでしょうか？
はい、間違いないです。
ではお願いします。柊木さん、
I'm just going to pause here.
Sure.
You might have noticed, but there's three specific perspectives here. One is the TV perspective. That is what you supposedly are seeing on TV.
Right.
You see the time, you see the whole title and stuff. Another one is the, I call it the city POV. So it's what the people in the city of Tokyo are actually seeing on the screen. So supposedly seeing, you know, this news on a huge TV in Shibuya. Mm-hmm. And the third one is the more intimate POV. That is, it takes place on the same studio, but the cameras are much closer to the characters, and supposedly it doesn't exist in this world, but it shows more so like what's happening through what the people want to see in the film.
Yeah, I mean, I noticed like there's different aspect ratios, like when you switch between what you see on TV and also the wide, the differences between like being
right
up close and, you know, watching it on TV.
Right, yeah, that's a really good point, because TV, which is 16:9 as opposed to a widescreen CinemaScope. And if you listen closely to this scene too, you'll actually hear this rumbling noise in this intimate POV in the background, because supposedly in the studio there's a bunch of you know, motors like running and like this like this huge like lower bass sound.
So like the motor stuff running, was that added in post, or was that just kind of already naturally on set?
Everything was added in post. The sound was completely constructed in post. Even the city sound, that was something that we didn't record on spot. We just got it recorded somewhere else.
Yeah, I think one of the other kind of interesting things is, like you said, we're shown three different perspectives, but like we're not really shown anyone else watching it. Because there's an absence of like people watching it, it's almost like, I think it's a big message of Stolen. It's just that like people interact with this as just news. Like it'll play on this big screen in a kind of city perspective, but in the backdrop or in the foreground, really, like people are just walking by. They're not even paying any attention. It's just, mm-hmm. to them, it's just like background noise, which is like, you know, I think it's really interesting.
Right. Yeah, although this is one of the bigger, supposedly bigger news in Japan, mm-hmm. When this is happening, still, you know, it's just like any other news. Like imagine like right now in early 2020, people don't stop like walking in Shibuya to watch news of like coronavirus,
right?
Even if it's like on big screen in Shibuya. So that's kind of like, also obviously practically we couldn't tell people to like stop and watch the screen. But I think it worked, you know, for us in this story.
あなたは偏った保守的な思想を持つ新聞社で15年もの間勤めてきました。その間問題となった記事の多くにあなたは関わってきました。最近でも反政府運動を弾圧するような記事が目立つといいます。平井さん、率直に聞きます。今回の失踪事件、世論操作を狙って意図的に仕組まれた自作自演だという噂、本当ですか？
全くもってデタラメだと断言いたします。私たちは
表現の自由の枠から逸脱するような報道を一切行っておらず、国民のプライバシーを侵害するような卑劣な行為に手を染めた事例もございません。私本人に限りましても、 法を犯すような強引な手段で政治に介入した経験はございません。ましてや実の息子を利用するなどという妄言を鵜呑みにすること自体、我々東家族に対する冒涜であると言います。
So basically, the father is a conservative journalist. What does it really mean to be a conservative journalist in Japan?
In Japan, it's a little bit different. A lot of it stems from the fact that Japan was right during the... Everything that Japan did during World War II was right. And it was the better... It would have been better for Asia as a whole, for Japan to, you know, keep occupying these countries in Japan. For a lot of people, the ultimate goal is for Japan to...have their own army. For this story in particular, it'll help the right-wing nationalists if North Korea would have kidnapped this child, because that's another reason to, I guess, like fight against oppression in North Korea and all these powers that are against Japan. Obviously, the father is aware that his company, his publication is considered conservative, right. Somewhat, and it is kind of like assumed that he does have those ideas himself. Mm-hmm. And he doesn't deny that even on the show when he's like denying a bunch of accusations. That's the one thing that he doesn't deny. So he mm-hmm. is, he does uphold those beliefs and thoughts that he has.
I think it's really interesting, like the way this, like the way you created this father character, like to have him have to balance like the pain of losing his, one of his sons. And mm-hmm. like, you know, also the other idea of like, you know, there's advantageous like aspects to this whole event happening. I think that's really like subtle, but it's like, it's not very present in the entire movie, but it's like something that he has to grapple with all throughout. And in this scene, it's really, really clear, I guess.
Right, for sure, for sure. But at the same time, obviously, the film is not about, I guess, condemning right-wing journalists and activists. Mm-hmm. This film definitely doesn't see, I guess, like depict the father as a villain just because he has, I guess, the ideas that a lot of people don't agree with.
陰謀論を唱え、好奇心を煽り立てるネットユーザーたちを私たちは非難いたしません。でもそのせいで無意味な波紋が広がり、私たち家族の会の活動に支障をきたしていることを理解してもらいたいです。たとえ両親といえども、中学生の息子を政治利用する権利が私たちにあるでしょうか。哲也は私たちの道具ではありません。
わかりました。
This is actually my favorite part of the scene, where a mom makes this very strong statement. That was, it was intended from the beginning that the mother is a very strong personality. She has a very strong personality and she's a very strong person. She was at one point a news reporter.
Oh, okay.
Yes, okay. When she was younger. And that's how she met the father. This is never clear in the film, but because of that background, she is, although she hasn't been working as a reporter for a while, she still can kind of like maintain that presence like on TV, and she can speak very articulately and all that, more so than the father. In an earlier scene, he says, he kind of... implies that the mother shouldn't, you know, speak screen, right. Because supposedly, you know, women look more historical when they're on screen, which mother points out because she is aware of all that culture that happens and goes on TV and news and entertainment in general. Mm-hmm. But what happens is that the father, he practices his speeches before. So he's supposedly very well prepared. But the mother, who is actually not, you know, who's actually speaking from her heart on the spot, you know, she didn't know that, you know, the news host is going to ask her a question and like make her speak. But because she has that strong belief, she can kind of like maintain that kind of like strong presence on screen, which when you look at this shot, father is definitely surprised to see. So this time is actually real time. It's synced to the actual length of the scene.
Oh, really?
Little gimmick, but just fun detail.
Yeah,
yeah. It's
not related to his
family. There's no big trouble. It's 我々両親が口出すことがないと信じております。
柊木さん、それがですね、ほんの数時間前の出来事ですが、いわゆる 実況放送をしていた
ネットジャーナリストを名乗る二人がお兄様から暴行を受けたと主張しており、その現場を捉えた映像がネット上で話題になっているとのことです。
ただいまこの動画を準備することはできませんが。
いや、その映像は
申し訳ありません。映像の方はただいまお見せすることはできませんが、
こちらに入りました情報によると、
哲也君のことを聞かれたのに対して知りたければ15日の試合に来いと言い放って暴力を振るったとのことです。
So you might have noticed this, but this is very film school 101.
Right.
Is the high angle
for sure.
To show people in trouble.
Mm-hmm. But they appear much weaker and out of control. Basically.
Exactly. As opposed to, I guess, the lower camera that's showing the TV host who is in power in this situation. You know, he has the power to not show the video and, you know, make the parents even more confused. Is how this TV host is kind of like bullying the father mm-hmm. and trying to see like how he will react to this whole, this whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
And create some sense of entertainment for this show. As a filmmaker, when people are just sitting and speaking, it's obviously harder to, you know, come up with like creative ways to show, you know, how they're reacting to situations, what's happening.
Right.
So we kind of resorted to more simpler, like I said, you know, filmmaking 101 kind of ways to, you know, show the inner turmoil. Is this high angle and also the shaky camera
right.
that we created.
Hirai-san, boxing の試合と哲也君の失踪、一体何の関係があるんですか？なぜお兄様は世間に対し挑発的な態度を？
This is like the first close-up that we actually got of not their faces.
It is.
Hirai-san.
But obviously the TV host catches it.
Right.
Because he's a pro and he does this kind of stuff for fun. He's supposedly that kind of character. Yeah, that's the whole purpose of this show. Supposedly,
he's just a douche. He's like uncovering,
but people like this.
People's
kind of people,
personal
so.
Lives.
So this is supposedly the payoff that I mentioned earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Is that? The intent was for people to, I guess, like forget that this is even like broadcasted towards the end of the scene when
yeah.
people are, you know, starting to feel this inner turmoil that father's going through and
yeah.
More curious as to like what the older brother did.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted people to forget that this was broadcasted. So there are a lot more shots towards the end where that takes place inside the studio,
right.
the invisible camera. And then at the end, I wanted to bring everything back to first the TV, where you zoom in, and then at the end, in the city, again, where people are supposedly seeing this and feeling this kind of like gotcha moment. It's called 11 Today.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
in the background, it says in Japanese, 11 Today.
Mm-hmm.
That is supposedly the name of the show.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a kind of a TV show that, you know, like stay-at-home mothers and like, you know, bored, like salaryman at work will watch while waiting for lunch. And to kind of have that, like, you know, sense of like entertainment and I guess like adrenaline rush. So that is happening, you know, in Japan while... Obviously, the parents are going through a completely different emotion,
yeah.
and hopefully, the audience too. You know, spending some time with the parents for 25 minutes by now, wanted to kind of like be on the side of the parents and know like what kind of stuff that people go through, because like this kind of stuff happens in real life. But I think them, the parents were pretty consistent throughout.
Yeah, I think it's just pretty amazing how. Like you were able to capture the nuances essentially, and you know, because like this scene really establishes the dynamics between the two, and like there are earlier scenes before for sure, but like you know the little looks, the way they react to certain you know tidbits of you know what each you know of the characters say, like to be able to kind of showcase all of that, and I guess such an important scene as well is really impressive.
Right, right, and you know usually as a filmmaker you're. Told not to kind of like resort too much to dialogue,
mm-hmm.
the exposition.
Mm-hmm.
This is a very dialogue heavy scene,
yeah.
But it is meant to be because they're on a news show But obviously, I didn't want to resort into like what they communicate. So definitely wanted to focus on like what's happening behind and what's happening within the characters that didn't express. And we used subtle camera movement and I guess like silence to convey that for this shot, which was a challenge, but I think it worked out pretty well.
Yeah, I honestly think it did. Nolan is currently on Amazon Prime, and you know, this is just one scene of the entire movie. And while this is an incredibly important scene, there's, you know, so many other scenes that are worth exploring further down. So go to Amazon Prime and check out the rest of the film.